Hello, everyone. Hoot hoot, everyone. It's me, Ethan, that there Turbo Owl. And I'm just here with a bit of an old brand new stream today. We're going to be playing Blood West. Let's just transition into it there. And get that music playing there. There we go. Yes! Blood West! If you don't know what Blood West is, I don't blame you. I don't know. I didn't really know what Blood West was either. It's apparently very positively received, however, looking at the star page. Blood West is a first... It describes itself as an immersive stealth FPS horror set in the Wicked Wild West. That is to say, a supernaturally influenced version of the Wild West. It's published and developed by Hyperstrange, that you may... A company whose name you may recognize if you were here for the postal brain-damaged stream, because it is a game that they made. It's the devs responsible for Postal Brain Damaged. I've played a little bit of Blood West, not all that much. I think, let me actually have a look at my playtime here. Yeah, I played like 15 minutes of it when it first entered into Early Access, and then I kind of put it down, with my plan being to, you know, give it a try on stream, and then I just never got back around to it until today. It's also worth noting, I keep forgetting this, but the developers, Hyperstrange, are, I believe, most well known for Elderborn, which I don't really know what kind of game it is. It looks like a first-person hack and slash kind of situation. Never played Elderborn myself, but I think that is the thing they're most well known for. Blood West has been, from everything I've seen discussing Blood West, it's been very well received. So hopefully this will go well. Also, do expect me to be fiddling around a bit with my camera, when we actually get into the game, because I don't know where the HUD is. Because again, I played this for 15 minutes like a month ago. Okay, you know what? Based on where that HUD is, I don't think I actually need to fuck around with my camera right now, because... Yeah, if nothing pops up there, it saves me having to fix it again when we go back into Yakuza tomorrow. Okay. And yeah, as you can see, much as you might expect from the developers of Elderborn, which I think had kind of a retro-ish aesthetic, and Postal Brain Damaged, it's doing the whole kind of crunchy, polygonal, pixelated 3D stuff here. Oh good, got a big old creepy skull.
It worked. It worked, and he is even in one piece.
Cool, I mean, getting some vibes, getting a very specific, the gargoyle heads from the medieval. You know, the old PS1 game Medieval, for some reason getting that specific vibe. Who are you?
Oh, me? You mean us? Nothing but an amalgamation of souls. More important question is, who are you?
I don't really know. Also, I don't know why I'm Bill S. Preston and or Theodore Logan for this one, but there we go.
The answer is, you're undead. We brought you here by means of our immense powers from whatever place you've been before.
If anyone calls me mate,
we know of
leaving.
Your exploits and achievements. Your fame reaches wide across the country. The nasty rumors about you reach even further. You're our ace in a sleeve. Before you ask, no, we cannot send you back. Not yet. See, that's the nature of every summoning. It must have a reason. And a reason you have. As an undead outside of others' influence, you will be our torch in the dark. Your spark will become the flame to purify the rot of this world and free us from the unending cycle of despair.
This is an awful lot to drop on a guy who presumably just died in his own world, you know? What should I do?
Search for the evil lurking in this world. Smell.
Kill evil stuff. Got it. Okay. Okay, I'm also actually just gonna quickly, Wait. Come on now. I've got to have audio options. There we go. Really? No.
Back again.
No master.
It's not cursed.
No master volume. Okay. It's never something. Jesus. It's never something I like. Is a lack of master volume. Oi, okay. So the game just felt a bit loud. Okay, we've got a button for toggling crouch and a button for not. Okay, there appears to be. There's a nightmare. We've got a meat nightmare. Oh, and we've got a very decisively informative. Thank you for the cheer. A very decisively informative bit of... Oh, is there a weapon over there? There's something shiny over there. Bit of information there for our little sound cues. Okay, no, that was... There is a skeleton.
Oh, good.
And a healing potion. Okay, I'm just gonna... Yeah. Just getting the fuck out of here right now. But yeah, got very good. Very nice that it makes it absolutely clear. Not only that you're making noise, but that the enemy is picking it up. That is something that I wish more stealth games... Actually, no, a lot of stealth games do... have something like that, where they have some kind of indicator that you're being spotted. And then we got kind of what, and almost like what I describe as a more RPG style. Oh, we're wearing gloves. For a second I thought we just had fucking Frankenstein hands. More RPG style inventory system. But yeah, that's how you can tell generally a bad stealth game, is if it's not, or a bad stealth section in a game, if the game's decided that it doesn't care enough to actually give you any kind of indication of how, like, aware of you the enemy is.
Match is death.
Oh shit, oh hello. Hi. Okay, well, I guess the stealth thing wasn't that important for these guys. Okay, the animate dead. Golden coin. Thank you. I'm assuming that's just money, right? Oh, no, nope, that's not money. That's a thing that it... Wait, what? Potato from obtaining a new soul flaw upon death. I don't know what that is, but you know what? I feel like I don't want a soul flaw. And a golden nugget. Okay, that's just something I could sell. Okay, so we're using dollary dues. Okay, I understand. What we got here? Oh, notes on animated dead? Animated dead, a seemingly mindless creature born from malicious dark magic. I'm immediately quite happy that they're actually giving me an explanation for the creatures. It's a small thing, it's something I always like in games where they have a guy... Where they have something that, like... dissects and goes into details about why the enemies are the way they are and how they work. I like, you know, your bestiaries. Your bestiaries. I like those. They could stare at a wall for hours, seemingly even enjoying it, and then shamble thoughtlessly around until they spot a living creature. Apparently, the sort of living beings wake something inside of them. A murderous instinct. They're basic melee enemies. They're weak melee enemies that are presumably only dangerous in packs. They're zombies by another name, essentially, it looks like.
I never have too much of those.
Okay, secondary weapon. We got a gun, ain't we? Hey, how you doing, bud? Can I not, like... be absolutely petulant and just destroy you for
you won't find any answers amusement? Lingering here. Better move towards the dark places and glimmering gold.
Okay. I mean, I'm not... I'm getting blood vibes from this guy. Yeah, you know what? I can't remember the name of the actor. Ooh, we actually have a journal as well. Cool. Oh, we got skill points. But yeah, I can't remember the name of the actor who played the cowboy, like the player character in Blood. But there is... I feel like the guy who's doing what little voice work our character here has is definitely trying to channel the guy from Blood. You know, Blood's a game that I really like the look of. I own... I can't what it's called. Is it like the, Blood Fresh Supply? Is that what it's called? That kind of re-release of it? That kind of cleaned up re-release? I'm just fucking terrible at it. Like, I am abominably bad at it. I can't even get past the first level of Blood, and it makes me sad. Because I want to like and play Blood, but I'm too bad at Blood. Safe zones. Cool. Here we can trade. Some enemies may respawn on your death or rest. Speak with the shaman and the totem of souls. Well, I literally just got a little icon of you, my guy, so...
What is it? A dead man I buried walks again. I sense the restless
I'm gonna
spirits
not read the
nearby,
fucking dialogue anymore.
But
I'm
still,
not, that's,
I hoped
no.
Your body would be protected by my charms. They were insufficient.
You are surprisingly calm about the fact that my ass is up and walking around. Now, I understand that there's Walking Dead everywhere, but, like, those don't seem chatty. I'm chatty. You should be surprised that I'm chatty. What the fuck happened? Okay.
Your body among the remains of monsters and decided to bury you in a manner akin to my tribe.
He's also wearing...
rituals, but it was not enough. And strong spirits have brought you back. I do not know if this is for a good or bad purpose.
Okay, the subtitles aren't quite matching his dialogue, but that's fine. He's got... Like, there's... Like, his mask isn't a million miles away from the Totem of Souls. You know, it's not 1,000 miles away. Who the hell are you?
I am nobody. Used to talk to spirits, guide the tribe. Now tribe shattered. I remain in shame, wandering the lands, trying to fix what can be fixed and lay to rest what is too broken. Good.
Cool.
Good. Walk on, tainted one, and let your journey.
Give him a hug with your axe.
Many a spirit here.
You know what? We'll trade with him, and then we'll see if we can give him a hug with our axe. Can we trade? Okay, I've got this. I've got a gold nugget for you. Okay, the reason the game was like, you should, trade if you get a map, is literally because it gave us exactly what we needed to get a map. Okay. Got a raven skull. Get some short ammo. Silver short ammo. Gold short ammo. Okay, gold short ammo increases damage against everything. Silver increases damage against spirits. I don't really need a knife. You know what? I don't want to buy anything right now. I will sell you this. I don't want to buy stuff. Actually, you know, I'll buy that. I'll buy some ammo. But I don't want to buy much, because I don't actually know what I'll need yet. You know? Oh, and we've leveled up. Shaman?
Lay your foot.
Can I help you?
You want to help. Odd, restless soul you are.
Fucking fun. I'm a fucking protagonist in a video game. Of course I want to help.
Take this packet. Journey past the tracks of Fiery Iron Horse. Find a cave, which used to be a burial site for many of my tribe. Leave it there. It will help the spirits. And if you kill any creatures disturbing the peace of spirits, it will be for greater good. I thank you,
cool.
Tainted One. There's nothing I can give you, but I am sure you will find something of use in the cave.
Oh yeah, don't worry, I'm gonna do some grave robbing while I'm there, don't you worry. Okay, I can't attack him. Like, you literally can't attack things in the safe zone. Okay. Leveling up. I have 3 skill points. I have 3 skill points. And a lot of skills. Oh god. I'll take Invisible Man. Being harder to see, it'll be good. Comfort weapon with a melee weapon and stamina. I'll take that as well. I'm comfortable now that I've got an axe. Hello, Soul Totem.
Since you're here, let us explain what is needed of you.
Yeah, that this fucking helps.
This has been corrupted by a curse, and you need to find its source. We don't know what has brought it to this land, so keep your eyes open. Bring us anything you may deem weird or disturbing.
Can I bring you? You're pretty fucking weird.
If you happen to get lost, come to us. We may be able to help or ease your burden. For now, we know where you can begin your search.
I feel like we definitely shouldn't trust this thing, right? Like, this doesn't feel great.
Follow the most strong scent of darkness around, under the burned church. Within ruined city, you will find part of your answers. Anything else? Ah, we could we? Yes, definitely. We could bless you. Not for free, mind you. We seek the cursed gold, the shining metal of doom and corruption. Bring it to us, so we may hide it from the mortal hands. You got the gold? Bury it beneath this totem and...
Cool, I'm leaving. Cool. God, no, he evil. Yeah, no, he's not great. There's no way he's on the level. No way on God's green earth. Okay. Like, he's definitely from. Also, I fucking hate the fact that the bits are animated in the chat. Because of that, my eye keeps getting drawn to the chat because I can see something moving, so I think the chat's moved up and it's driving me up the fucking wall. Okay. Got more ammo.
Bullets.
Can I, like, swap? Wait, what ammo did I just load into it? Oh, no, wait, I should be on the other one. Okay, hang on. There we go. You know, no one, that might have been you being deliberately obnoxious, but it did actually push the bits off of my screen, so that has actually helped. Oh, dear. Are we supposed to be going this way? It said, like, follow... Okay, well, the Johnny Depp from the Lone Ranger character did tell us to follow the tracks of the Fiery Iron Horse, which I assume means the train. But, okay, yeah, no, that side is empty. Oh, God. No, I just shouldn't even really be worried about these things. I mean, I can one-shot these. That's fine. Oh, wow, they're actually a lot faster than I... Oh! Okay, I should worry about these things. Cool, I should have worried about those things. I severely underestimated how dangerous those were.
Again.
This motherfucker is definitely... This fucking character is 100% supposed to be a fucking riff on... Is it Caleb? I want to say Caleb? Is the cowboy from Blood? He just literally said, I live again. And honestly, there's a more than 0% chance, if you ask me, that he might actually be voiced by the same guy. I don't know if he is or not, but... Also, I'm gonna quickly swap a key binding round. Because I keep trying to... Swap, there we go. Because I keep trying to toggle crouch with control rather than C. I don't know why. I have never understood, especially in stealth games, I will never understand these motherfuckers. Who prefer holding down the crouch button. They're fucking psychopaths. Anyone who prefers holding a button down to a toggle is a fucking nightmare monster. But yeah, given the fact that fucking the guy who voiced Caleb in Blood has appeared in, like, I know this isn't a new Blood game, but he's appeared in Dusk. Like, he was, the voice of Caleb was the last boss of Dusk. I definitely played Dusk on the channel, right? I'm pretty sure I played it to completion on the channel. Dusk's fucking great. God, I love Dusk. Oh, is that... Wait, is this the... Oh, is this the secret spirit cave that the guy wanted me to go through? Or have I just wandered into a different cave? I might have just wandered into a different cave, but whatever. Well, there's old corpses in here rather than recent animated ones, so this could be the right cave.
To ashes. Death. Stay down.
Yeah, these things are actually a lot tougher than I was expecting. Okay, Oh god, we can't use this shit in my inventory. I have to actually equip it and then take it out. Okay. At least we got another bandage back quite quickly. Yeah, so there's a chance that that could actually be the guy who played Caleb. It's been a long time since I, like, even looked at Blood. So, I just don't actually remember particularly well what he sounds like. Honestly, most of my experience with Blood come... Oh god, that's something new. Most of my experience with Blood comes very specifically from, watching... CV11's Pro Blood series. Oh good, this was the place where I was supposed to go. But there's very little of use to me. Oh, hang on.
Need that. Oh good, ammo.
Is it worth me looking up to see, like, Googling who's doing the voice of the main character in this game? Is it worth me doing that? Because it's not going to be the guy from Blood.
Let's put these to good use.
It's definitely not going to be the guy from Blood. It's definitely... It's 100% a dude doing, like, an impression or something. Like, I'm just trying to channel the dude from Blood rather than actually being the dude from Blood, right? Okay, Okay, well, we've now got a bow and arrow as well as a pistol. It is notable, I think, that our side weapon is the pistol. I mean, I'll grant you, historically, pistols are sidearms rather than primary weapons. But it's weird that the main weapon... Ah, shit. Nope. I'm in danger!
Not just death.
Oh, you get your arrows back!
Job done.
Oh, but there's a risk. Okay, there's arrows. Okay, that's it. I'm Googling it. Sorry, I need to... Hang on. Blood West voice actor. Hang on. Okay, no. It's not... Okay. It's not the guy from Blood. this game have, like, a... This game, I don't... Yeah, okay. I don't even... I don't know who the fuck it is, a voice is in, but it's not the guy. I have now proven to my own satisfaction it's not the guy from Blood. Although that guy is apparently in, he is apparently in Ultra Kill. Which is another game that I put up there with, oh shit, I probably should have been crouching, huh? Which is a game that I put up there with a medieval as, like, games that I definitely should play at some stage, but I just haven't yet. I've heard nothing but good things about both A Medieval and Ultra Kill, but for some reason, and I own both of them, they're both in my library, but for some reason I've just never brought myself to play them. I've played more Nightmare Reaper than I've played either of those, and I literally just requested review code for Nightmare Reaper on a whim. Whereas I, like, actively sought out those other two. What's this?
You never have too much of those.
Ooh. Raven's Skull. Oh, that was the thing that teleports me back to the totem. Yeah, okay. Notes on a Prodigal Daughter. An interesting study could be written by observing the alteration known as... Okay, is that what the monsters are being called in this game? Alterations? Well, that's Lord, what the fuck is going on with you? Like, you just... Why are you typing gibberish down there, my guy? In the circles of the hunters and daredevils brave enough to venture into the barren lands, while it remains mostly human, at least on first glance, the damage done by dark magics to its brain seems to be the most severe, even if it maintains the ability to speak. Creature suffers from heavy case of megalomania, seeing itself as a beautiful young lady and demanding total and unconditional admiration from the whole world, all while wearing a mask that hides defamation and dreadful countenance, and carrying a shotgun. Wait, what was that? Wait, okay, don't break its mask, or was that break its mask? Hang on. Therefore, it is best to kill the prodigal daughter swiftly, if possible, as any prolonged combat may prove fatal. Shooting it in the face will break the mask and make the creature more aggressive, which may be undesirable. Anything that may reveal the ugliness, be it a living being or an inanimate object like a mirror, becomes the target of vicious and furious attack, which will not cease its attack until the target has been destroyed, or annihilated. You didn't realize you were typing backwards. Fucking get your brain checked if you can accidentally start typing backwards and not realize. That's either a sign of severe mental illness or demon possession. But, like, very specifically lame demon possession, because typing backwards doesn't have anywhere near the oomph of talking backwards. And even talking backwards is, Oh, don't even want to know what's going on with that. And even talking backwards is kind of old hat for demonic possession, you know what I'm saying? They're definitely enemies, right? I can't imagine it's just non-hostile gobbledygook floating around. Okay. There's a church there, and I was told to head in that direction. But at the same time, what's over here? Oh. But at the same time, what's over here? Oh God.
Righteous death.
The fuck is this thing? Birdman! Is that like, as in Ingvar? Birdman? I know it's Bergman, not Birdman, but... As in Ingvar Birdman? It's a weird thing that Twitch's text bar does. What, Twitch? What, you can choose to let Twitch... What? Twitch just has an option to let you type backwards? Why?
And stay down.
Now, you see, the thing that... The noise that made when it died was very loud. And... I'm very concerned that anytime I kill one of those, everything within like a 5-mile radius is gonna hear about it. Whoops. 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 Hang on. Let me just, get one of these.
Get back to hell.
Gonna be honest, I'm not the biggest fan of those noises. Oh, what the fuck? I'm not the biggest fan of those sounds. Not at all. Oh shit. At least I reacted quite quickly. Now when I turn Twitch on, my line that shows me typing is always in a weird position because I'm typing to go in reverse. Okay, you know, the more you try and explain this, the weirder it's sounding. I don't think I've ever run into a situation in which someone just keeps making stuff more confusing the more they try and, like, explain their situation. So... Okay. Half risen dead. It had a shell on it. Oh god. Which meant it was tougher. Nope, 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 nope. Ow. Oh god. Oh god.
Stay dead, pal.
Okay, so that's a ranged enemy, I guess. Because it, like... fires goop at me. Okay, so we know what that enemy is. That enemy was Gwyneth Paltrow. Because we just had goop fired at us. Joke about the brand goop.
Scum of the earth.
Okay. God, I hope I'm able to sell these revolvers, otherwise I'm just gonna be carrying around a shitload of revolvers for no good reason. Okay. Ooh. Is that a shotgun? I think the Winchester is just a rifle, isn't it?
Let's put these to good use.
Huh.
to rest.
But I mean, this is kind of doing it for me, because right now I can just kind of... snipe him out for a bit. The birdman over there who spotted me. And now we just got... Hang on, you know what? Can I? I can throw a grenade. I've got a grenade, right? What? Dynamite. Yeah, that'll fucking do it. Come here. Yeah, that'll do that. Lovely. Okay, what else we got? You know what? Let's actually get... let's get this self-learner thing here. Because as it's, as is always the case, the best time to get... the best time to get stuff that increases your XP gain is as early on as possible. It doesn't matter what game you're in. Just being able to flatly increase your XP gain for the entire, like, experience is always a good thing. Is that, like, the whole place? Nope. No, it is not. It's most the place, but yeah, there's still a few here. Human peed. I don't like that thing. I don't want that thing around me. Wait, what the fuck can see me? I'm also gonna be honest with you. Not the biggest fan of the fact that I can, like, constantly hear, like, what sounds like weird ambient ghost sounds. Oh, sweet Jesus. I don't know how to deal with these things. Other than that, that's more or less the only way I have for dealing with them, but that's, like, also not great, because it involves me getting right up next to them. Which I don't like, because they're very tough. I was gonna say, I killed the birdman up here, didn't I? Yeah. I'm gonna stop picking up guns.
That'll come in handy.
A cigar box. I guess just valuables, I guess. You always need to get valuables. If Valuables are always good. In any stealth game, you need valuables. Come on. Oh, hang on. Fucking, what the hell's that? Shotgun shells. Again, we keep getting shotgun shells. That's getting having a shotgun. I'm going to go ahead and say limited usefulness. Dynamite.
To rest.
Yeah, it really does seem like the dynamite is basically the only way to deal with those big bastards in boxes. Didn't even break the box, it just killed him. Oh god.
The voices never stop talking.
Oh god, there's like two of them.
I think nope. I had a dream. Or was it a dream of a dream?
God damn it!
Never trust a stranger. To find a good slave around here. Diamonds are forever.
Ratchet's death.
Okay. That's the chick on the menu. Yeah, it is, yeah. Yep, yes it is.
Good ammo.
Did you just ask why it was so hard to find a good slave? Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and assume... I'm gonna go ahead and hope... That's her asking it in the context of, like, the note. That described them as... In the context of, like, the note that described them as being, like, incredibly up their own asses. Rather than a heavy-handed reference to, slavery, which I realize that given the, like, rough time period that this is, like, addressing, ain't great. Basically, they're into S&M. Yeah, more or less. God damn it. Shit. I mean, okay, we can drop the note. can't believe how much, like, inventory management this is requiring of me. Ah! I hadn't realized we can just rotate them. Okay, hang on. Okay, there we go, and then... There we go, okay. Inventory management, excellent. Anyone ever played Diablo? Fucking Christ. Equip the artifacts. No, because they don't... They don't actually help me. Nope, shit. Probably would help if I could aim, wouldn't it? I don't have any dynamite, so I can't really deal with the big guys. That's the shotguns better dealing with them, which may very well be the case for all I know. So that's the thing, I'm not doing much in the way of commentary right now, because I'm just playing the game. This is the problem with stealth games. I'm having to focus on them. Oh god, yep, there he is. What the fuck these things are throwing at me. Oh, it's chunks of the coffin.
The freak.
Jesus. Oh, okay. Okay. Although, to be fair, this does answer my question how to deal with these things. Shotgun. The shotgun deals with these things. It would have helped if I wasn't just constantly hitting the casket and was actually doing damage to the guy, though. That would have been... That would have been slightly better.
To hell.
That was also probably a waste... of a shot. I should probably, yeah, go back to sneaking and trying to hit stuff with the axe unless I have to do something else. Because the axe is, yeah. That'll do it.
I'll believe that.
Oh, that's like... That's an actual revolver instead of a shit revolver.
done. Stay dead.
And I'm dead. Okay. You know,
live again.
Oh god. You know what? It's a bit of a short one, but I didn't sleep very well last night, so actually let's talk to this guy.
I sense the spirits of my
reward,
male footsteps.
Let's actually also sell some of this shit before I completely check out here. Yeah, I'm calling it here. The game seems pretty good. This is the problem, right? It's one of the issues I have when it comes to doing impressions, reviewing stuff, that kind of stuff, getting review codes and stuff, is that I'm very fucking moody, and right now I've been, like, very specifically in a strategy game mood. I've been in the mood to play strategy games and Yakuza. If I was in a stealth horror mood, which is a mood I'm in relatively frequently, I'd be really into this. This game seems quite fun. I don't know, there's something about the enemies that throws me off a bit, though. I think it's because in an ideal world, I'd be able to react to them a bit better. Considering that the moment they spot you, they fucking sprint at you. And I get that the game is intended to be like horror, or a stealth game before more than an action game. But, I don't know, there's just something about the fact how relatively sluggish we are compared to the enemies that, makes the game, I don't know, it just feels a bit off. But, other than that, yeah, it's pretty good. There will be a link in the description if you're watching the VOD after the fact. To where you can pick this game up on Steam. As I say, it's currently in early access. But yeah, so tomorrow I will be back with some more Yakuza 2 Kiwami, and we're going to start focusing down the main plot line from tomorrow on. I will also say I may be late tomorrow because my brother has finally managed to force me out of my house. My brother has finally managed to force me out of my house to go meet my nephew. Because in case you didn't know, my brother has a son now, relatively recently, and I'm therefore an uncle. However, I hate children, so I've been avoiding having to interact with it. I've run out of ways to avoid having to meet my nephew. So, I'm gonna be doing that tomorrow, which means I may end up knackered by the time that's done, because, you know, people, and I have to wake up early, so I may end up streaming a bit later tomorrow, because I'm gonna be getting a nap when I get back. But either way, even if it's a bit late, I will be back with some more. How old are they? Oh, it's less than a year. It's a baby. They're a tiny little baby, but I also hate babies, so there you go. But I'll be back with some more Yakuza tomorrow, even if it's a bit late. Hope you guys enjoyed the stream, and I'll see you next time. Bye!